Okay, welcome students. Today we will see remaining basic terminologies or terms that we use in the study of ecology. Okay, first we will study what is ecosystem. Here, suppose there in a given area all the living organisms are present, we call it as biotic assemblage, and it includes animals, plants, as well as all other type of living organisms. They interact with their physical environmental factors in such a manner that there is flow of energy leading to trophic structures, and thus biotic diversity, material cycles within such a system, and such system is known as ecosystem. Okay. Means ecosystem includes biotic component plus abiotic component plus there should be flow of energy in that system, and such type of combination is called as ecosystem or simply ecological system. Okay, then next we will see some definitions of biosphere, standing state, standing crop, biosphere, what is standing state, then standing biomass, ecological pyramid. We'll see one by one these definitions. Here, ecosystem is whole biotic community in that area plus its abiotic environment. Then the earth's living organism with their physical environment may be considered as a giant or largest ecosystem. Okay. Now, this system is designated as biosphere or ecosystem. It is biosphere. Complete earth ecosystem, when its all living organism, biotic organism or biotic components and all factors combine or act as a single ecosystem or single ecological system, then such system is considered as biosphere. Okay. Thus, the planet Earth along with atmosphere, that is land, water, air, that sustains life is known as biosphere. Okay. Then, next point we will see what is standing state and standing biomass. Here, the amount of inorganic substances, amount of inorganic substances present at any given time in environment or in ecosystem is known as standing state. Here, inorganic substances like carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, phosphorus, sulfur, etc. and their amount present in that particular ecosystem is called as standing state. Okay. That matter depends on which type of ecosystem we select or present in the nature. Then next, the amount of living material. Okay. What is standing crop? the amount of living material present in component population at any time is known as standing crop. Next is standing crop. It includes amount of biomass in living population. Then when biomass is standing crop expressed in terms of weight of the ecological system, then we have to see ecological pyramids. What are ecological pyramids? Ecological pyramids are the graphic representation of various trophic levels and their functions at successive stages or successive trophic level from base to apex of the ecosystem. And there are different types of pyramids, like pyramid of number, pyramid of biomass, pyramid of energy, etc. It is the pyramid. Then next we have to study food chain, food web, productivity, etc. Now what is food chain, food web and productivity? That we will study. In an ecosystem, various living organisms, whether they are plants or organisms, they are arranged in a definite sequence according to their food habits, and such sequence is called as food chain. For example, if we arrange grass, then grass is eaten by certain insect, such insect is eaten by frog, and then frogs are eaten by snake. Okay, all these are the living organisms in a particular ecosystem. These organisms are arranged in a succession of their feeding habit or prey predator mechanism type. Here initial these are producers. Grass is cropping level first, it is second, then third, then fourth, etc. Such a system of interrelated with each other, it is called as food chain. Okay, it is a simplest food chain present in environmental system. Then plants are producers, they are eaten by herbivorous organisms, and in turn herbivorous organisms are eaten by the carnivorous organism. And during this process there is flow of or transfer of food energy from the source plant to the highest level of organisms, and such system is called as food chain. Then next, what is food web? Here various such food chains, they are interrelated with each other. They may be crisscross type, and a web like appearance occurs, or certain complex structure occur, that is called as food web. Okay, this can be further increased. Okay, insect, there may be other carnivorous organisms which can feed on frog. There should be other carnivorous organisms. There should be other herbivorous organisms which feed on grass, like they may be a rabbit. And then further on in this way, this grass may be eaten by cows, buffaloes, etc. And there is further another food chain start. In this way, such a food chains, their appearance looks like interlocked or they are bisecting each other, and such appearance of food chains is called as food web. Okay, then though food web occurs, it is important definition in the study of ecology. And then productivity, that is rate of production. Here we know that grasses or simply plants are primary producers. We consider plants are primary producers. These plants, they trap solar energy at the time of photosynthesis and convert solar energy into chemical utilizable form in the form of food. Okay, in the form of food, that energy is stored, and this energy is available to next level organisms or all other living organisms present on earth. This productivity is used or called as primary productivity, and this productivity are of two types: primary productivity, secondary productivity, then gross primary productivity and net primary productivity, etc. This productivity we see in details in further purpose. Okay. Then next, biogeochemical cycles. Next, we will see what is biogeochemical cycles. Here, it is less or more a circular pathway through which chemical elements present in ecosystem or present in nature, they are like protoplasm, they circulate in the biosphere from environment to organism and back to the environment. Here, like chemical material or chemical elements which are used for living organisms, these chemical elements present in nature, they are used by living organisms. Then, after the death of living organisms, these chemical elements are again in the nature. This more or less circular flow of chemical elements from nature, or we simply say it as ecosystem to living organisms, that is biotic system, and again back to the abiotic system. Such cyclic flow of various chemicals, these chemicals may be carbon, it may be carbon, nitrogen cycle, phosphorus cycle, sulfur cycle, etc. All these are called as biogeochemical cycles. Okay. Then next we have to see what is ecological leaking and ecological equivalence. As we have studied that every organism has its home or living state or living place in the ecosystem or nature. that such a place is called as habitat, where the organisms actually live or they live in the nature. But here ecological decay is somewhat broader concept. It includes its habitat as well as the organism's role in that particular nature or that particular level. Ecological decay. Ecological decay, it includes physical space occupied by organism, then its functional role in the community, that is its trophic position. We had studied trophic level 1, 2, 3, etc. And its position in environment gradients of temperature, moisture, pH, soil, etc. And the conditions of existence. Okay. And such are called as ecological decay. And in general, there are three types of ecological decay. Okay. Habitat decay, trophic decay, and multi-purpose. Okay. These are ecological decays. Then last definition we have to study, that is conservation and pollution. What is conservation? Conservation means to ensure the preservation of quality of environment for the organisms in terms of their nutrition, recreation, etc. And to ensure same time through planned manipulation. Okay. It is called as conservation. And what pollution occur? Pollution is any undesirable change in the physical, chemical or biological characteristic of our air, land, water, etc. that may affect various living organisms. It is called as pollution. Okay. Hence, we have completed this today's topic. We will stop here.